Students, today's class we are going to see solar energy reaching the earth surface. So solar radiation is an electromagnetic radiation emitted by the sun. So sun is converting its mass into light particles called photons. So the solar radiation that reaches the different locations of the earth, which depends upon the several factors, for example geographical location, time, season, local landscape and local weathers. So earth rotates around the sun in an elliptical orbit, which is closer to the sun during the part of the year, and sometimes it is farther to the sun during some part of the year. When sun is near to the earth surface receives little more solar energy, and the rotation of the earth is also responsible for hourly variation in the sunlight. When sunlight passes through the atmosphere, it is subject to absorption, scattering and reflection by air molecules, by water vapor or some clouds, or it may be some dust materials, pollutions, forest fires. These are all the subject to the reflections. When photon is absorbed, the energy is changed into electrical energy or heat energy. Scattering occurs when the gas molecules and small particles diffuse from the incoming solar radiations in different direction without any alteration of the wavelength of the electromagnetic energy. So reflection of the radiation is the process where sunlight is redirected by 180 degree after it strikes the atmospheric particle. The radiation intensity on the surface of the sun is approximately 6.33 × 10⁷. The solar energy reaching the earth atmosphere to be constant for all the practical purpose, we call it as a solar constant. So because of this difficulty, it is very difficult to achieve the accurate measurement or the exact value of the solar constant. So solar constant value is estimated on the basis of the solar radiation received per unit area, which is perpendicular to the rays of the sun, average distance between the sun and the earth. Since the radiation spreads out in the distance squared by it travel to the distance one unit, we call it as roughly we are saying that the distance between the sun and the earth is astronomical unit AU. The radiant energy falling on this area is reduced. There is a variation in the solar intensity if it is in the slow cycle or if it is in the high cycle. So these are all the things we have to consider while you are going for the generation of electricity or we are using the solar energy for the various applications. What are the problems associated with the harnessing of full solar energy? That means extracting full solar energy. There are three important reasons why we cannot done full solar energy. First one is the earth is displaced from the sun. So sun's energy spreads out like light from the candle. Only small fraction of energy is leaving an area of the sun which is reaches to the equal area in the earth. The earth rotates about its polar axis, that is any collection device which should be located on the earth surface can receive the sun radiation energy for only half of the day. Because it is moving like this, half a day you will get that full energy. And least predictable factor is nothing but the shell, thin shell of the atmosphere which surrounds the earth surface. So earth atmospheric accounts for 30% of reduction of sun energy. That means 70% only the sun energy can be obtained. But we have the device to absorb only 40% of the sun energy. Weather conditions are also, we have to think of it, it may be stop the minimal amount of solar radiation from reaching the earth surface for many days in a row. So next one is we are going to see is solar constant. It is a measure of flux density and the amount of incoming solar electromagnetic radiation per unit. It includes all type of solar radiation. It's not just visible light. Solar energy reaching the periphery of the energy atmosphere is considered to be constant for all practical purpose and is known as solar constant. So solar constant value is estimated basis of the solar radiation receives on unit area exposed perpendicular to the rays of the sun. Next one is a solar spectrum. While talking about this solar spectrum, we have various spectrum is there. Variation of irradiance with the wavelength of the solar radiation is called as solar radiation spectrum. Various energy are stored in that solar spectrum. Spectrum is nothing but collection of waves or signals, wavelength, frequency, anything else. So here there are five regions are there in the spectrum according to the wavelength. First one is ultraviolet C range, UVC range, and ultraviolet B range, ultraviolet A range, visible range, and infrared range. UVC range in the sense it spans from the range of 0.1 micrometer to 0.28 micrometer. It is the radiation at the high frequency than the violet light. Absorption by atmosphere, that means only mere amount of the amount reaches the earth surface called the lithosphere. And UVB range is nothing but ranges from 0.28 micrometer to 0.315 micrometer. It is responsible for the photochemical reaction leading to the production of the ozone layer. And next one is ultraviolet A, that is UVA range. So UVA range in the sense it ranges from 0.315 micrometer to 0.4 micrometer. It is less damaging to DNA and used in tanning and PUVA, that is photochemical UVA therapy, for the psoriasis. This therapy, for that we are using the range. Next one is a visible range of light, that is 0.38 to 0.78 micrometer, which is used for the communication purpose there. It is visible to the naked eye. Next one is nothing but infrared range. It spans from 0.7 micrometer to 1000 micrometer. It is responsible for the important part of the electromagnetic radiation that reaches the earth. It is also again classified into three types. One is infrared A, infrared B, infrared C. Infrared A in the sense it's ranges from 0.7 micrometer to 1.4 micrometer. Infrared B is 1.4 micrometer to 3 micrometer, and infrared C is 3 micrometer to 100 micrometer. So biologically it is important output from the sun reaching the earth surface can be divided into 4 wavelength, that is ultraviolet B, UVB, ultraviolet A, and visible light and infrared. These are the 4 important wavelength is required for the sun's earth relationship. So ultraviolet wavelength is shorter than the 0.28 micrometer heavily absorbed by the molecular oxygen or ozone and water vapor in the upper atmosphere that do not reach the surface of the earth. So the major source of damaging the sunlight comes primarily from the ultraviolet portion of the spectrum, that is 0.29 micrometer to 0.4 micrometer, that is UVB and UVA. Next we are going to see that solar radiation outside the atmosphere, earth atmosphere. So it is the measurement that energy radiation received from the sun outside the earth atmosphere. So it is ISC, we used to say that a solar constant is the rate at which the energy is received from the sun on unit perpendicular to the rays of the sun at the mean distance. Next, solar radiation on the earth surface, that is given by the rate at which the solar energy reaches the unit area of the at the earth is called as solar irradiance or solar insolation. Insolation means sun's energy received over the horizontal surface. The unit of measure of irradiance is watts per square meter. Solar insolation is nothing but instantaneous measure of rate that can vary over the time. The maximum solar irradiance value is used in the system to determine the peak rate of the energy input to the system. If the storage included in the system design, then the designer also consider that how much irradiance over the time for the particular design. Since that there are solar radiation reaching the earth surface may be defined in various terms like beam radiation or direct solar radiation, diffuse radiation and global radiation, and air mass also to be considered. So next one is a solar thermal energy application. Energy application in the sense the energy from the sun can be converted into usable form of energy for multiple purpose. Like we have various system, the technologies consists of two systems. One is a passive system, another one is an active system. Passive system in the sense which collects the energy without need of pumps or motors, which will collect the energy without need of pumps or motors. Generally, the orientation of materials, constructions of the collectors are made up of like without any pumps or fans or any kind of parameters is required. So this property allow the collector to absorb and store and use the solar radiation. So passive systems are particularly suited to design the building and thermosiphoning solar hot water system. For new buildings, passive system is generally very low and no additional cost because they are simple, take advantage of the orientation and the building to capture the used solar radiations. So passive solar system relies on the natural resources to transfer the heated water to for the domestic purpose. Active system in the sense it is most common system use pumps to circulate the water or another heat absorbing fluid through the solar collectors. These collectors are commonly made up of copper tubes bonded to the metal plate, painted black, encapsulated with the insulation box covered by the glass panel, or we used to say that glazing. For pool heating or other kind of applications, these will be used. So here how the sun energy will be used in the sense it is in the form of solar energy. Either we can use as a light or we can use as a heat. If you are using as a light, then it is converted into DC in the solar cell, then it is stored in the battery storage, then the from the battery to AC converter, then AC to we can use it in the multiple applications. Or we can use as hydrogen as a fuel, then the fuel will be converted into electricity, then we can use this one. Or the hydrogen fuel is directly used for the vehicle movement. If it is a thermal energy in the sense the heat energy is converted into thermal energy, that is thermal energy, heat energy are same. So that will be given to the waste heat storage, then it is given to the heating and cooling equipment and piping network, then it is used for some kind of solar cooker or solar water heater, or it may be some kind of furnace boiling. For that purpose we are using this solar heat or thermal heat. So there are two types of application. One is direct thermal application and solar electric conversion. That means solar energy is converted into two ways. One is thermal applications, another one is solar electric conversions. Thermal application in the sense we are heating, we are using the heat of the sun directly for some applications. Or we are converting the solar radiation into light and the light will give the electricity. So solar radiation into electricity or solar radiation into heat. So thermal application in the sense low temperature solar thermal system, domestic water cooling system, crop drying, day lighting systems and heating and cooling systems are used. Solar electric conversion and application in the sense we are using for the thermoelectric mechanical conversions, basic Rankine cycle and photovoltaic conversions. For that purpose we are using this one. So passive systems, which is used for building the thing that we discussed previously, and this is active system we discussed, drain back system and direct thermal solar energy system. Here the sun energy is collected directly to create the high temperature steam and low temperature heat for the use of variety of heat and power applications. So it is also classified as a low, medium, high temperature collectors. Low temperature collectors are a flat plate collectors used for the heat swimming pool. Medium temperature collectors are used for heating the water. High temperature collectors are used for generation of the electricity. And low temperature solar thermal system consists of the nearly 6 applications like space heating, domestic and industrial hot heating, pool heating, desalination, that is converting the solar, the salt water into pure water, solar cooking and crop drying. These are all the applications of the solar thermal system.